Good morning, students. Let's start the chapter, that is chapter number 12, Exponents and Powers. Exponents and powers. First, let's understand what is the meaning of exponents, and then we'll discuss some laws of exponents, which we have already learned earlier also. So the first one, that is, if I write a raised to the power 2, it means a into a. A raised to the power 3, it means a into a into a. Similarly, if I write a raised to the power m, it is equal to a into a into a into a m times. It is multiplied m times. For example, if you have 2 raised to the power 3, it is equal to 2 into 2 into 2, and the value of this will be equal to 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8. If it is 3 raised to the power 2, it is 3 into 3. 3 power 2, so 3 is written twice, 2 times, 3 into 2, 3 into 3. So 3 into 3, that is equal to 9. So this is the meaning of a raised to the power n. Now we'll discuss the laws of exponents. Now in this we see that when we write a raised to the power n, this term a, this is known as base, and m, this is known as power, and the whole a raised to the power m, we call it as exponent. So the numbers can be written in the form of exponent. As we have seen, 8, we can write it as 2 into 2 into 2, that is 2 raised to the power 3. If we have 32, it is 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, 5 times. So that becomes 2 raised to the power 5. So this is the value of the exponent, and this is the number written in the exponent form. And basically you can see here, we have taken it as the powers of prime numbers. Similarly, if you have 50 can be written as prime factors 2 into 5 into 5. That means this we can write it as 2 raised to the power 1 into 5 raised to the power 2. So this number 50 is written in the form of product of exponents. Or we can proceed, take some more examples. Let's see how to write this. This is 192, write as the power of exponent, product of exponents. ये बच्चों आपने 7th क्लास में भी पढ़ा था, write as product of exponents. So what we need to do, we have to find out the prime factors of 192 के हम prime factors निकालना है. It is divisible by 2, 96, again it is divisible by 2, 48 times, again divisible by 2, 24, again divisible by 2, it is 12, again divisible by 2, it is 6, and further again divisible by 2, it is 3. So this is 192 is written as 2 2 raised to the power 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 192 we can write it as 2 raised to the power 6 multiplied by 3 is only 1, so 3 raised to the power 1. So this way we have written this, any number we can write it as the product of exponents. This you have already learned in class 7th also, students. Now let's recall the laws of exponents. Laws of exponents with some examples as well. So laws of exponents. The first law is known as product rule. Product rule, which says a raised to the power m multiplied by a raised to the power n, it is equal to a raised to the power m plus n. A power m into a power n is equal to a power m plus n. Remember this, you can see here, this bases are same. And when we multiply the exponents, the powers will be added. This can be applied for more than two exponents also. Like this, if you have a power m into a power n into a power p, then it is equal to a power m plus n plus p. A power m plus n plus p. So this can be applied for more than two exponents also. Product of more than two exponents. But the condition is they should have the same base. With same base. Second one. That is a power m quotient rule or division rule. Quotient rule or division rule. A power m divided by a power n. This is equal to a raised to the power m minus n. A power m divided by a power n. This is equal to a raised to the power m minus n. Third rule is exponent rule, or you can say power of power. Exponent rule, which is also known as power of power, that we can see as a raised to the power m whole raised to the power n. This is equal to a raised to the power m into n. Now let's see the fourth law of exponent, which you have already learnt in class 7th again. The fourth law of exponent is a raised to the power 0 is equal to 1. And the condition is a should not be equal to 0. That means if you have 0 raised to the power 0, 0 raised to the power 0, it is not equal to 1. This is an indeterminate quantity. Indeterminate, which cannot be determined. Indeterminate means which cannot be determined. So 0 raised to the power 0 is an indeterminate. Okay, if it is 0 raised to the power 0, it is indeterminate. Or you can say it is undefined, not defined yet. किसी ने अभी तक इसकी value calculate नहीं की है. यह आपके लिए challenge है, आप calculate कर सकते हैं. 0 raised to the power 0. Okay, now this is 9 raised to the power 0. The value will be equal to 1. If it is 9999999999, again raised to the power 0, again the value is equal to 1. 5 upon 17 raised to the power 0, again the value is 1. Any number raised to the power 0, any non-zero number raised to the power 0 is always equal to 1. Even if I write 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus dash 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 1000, power 0 laga diya, आपको इसको कैलकुलेट करने की जरूरत ही नहीं है, कोई जरूरत नहीं कि हम इसको पूरा ऐड करें उसके बाद पावर जीरो करें। सॉरी आपने देखा पावर जीरो है तो आंसर इसका डेफिनेटली क्या हो जाएगा, वन। ओके देन फर्दर Now let's take some examples. If the question is find the value of 1 upon 2 raised to the power 0 plus 1 upon 3 raised to the power 0 plus 1 by 4 raised to the power 0. 1 upon 2 raised to the power 0, this is equal to 1. 1 by 3 raised to the power 0 is also equal to 1. 1 by 4 raised to the power 0 is also equal to 1. And we get 1 plus 1 plus 1, this is equal to 3. And then second part. Find the value of 5 power 0 into 7 power 0 into 999 power 0. Again, 5 power 0 is 1. 7 power 0 is 1. 999 power 0 is also 1. And 1 into 1 into 1 is equal to 1. Any number 1 is multiplied as many number of times 1 ko aap kitni bhi baar multiply kar loge to aapka answer hamesha kya aayega, 1। यहाँ पे बच्चे क्या गलती करते हैं, 1 into 1 into 1 is 3, 1 plus 1 plus 1 is 1। तो जब addition कर रहे हैं तो जितनी बार add किया 1 को वो आपका आंसर होगा। 1 को यदि 5 times add करेंगे तो 5 आंसर होगा, 1 को 10 times add किया तो 10 आंसर होगा, 1 को यदि m times add किया है तो m आंसर होगा। लेकिन जब आप 1 को multiply करोगे 1 raised to the power 2, 1 raised to the power 3, 1 raised to the power 5, 1 raised to the power 100, it is always equal to 1. Okay, now we'll be discussing the exponents with negative power. Exponents with negative power. Our today's topic further is exponent with negative power or power with negative exponents, you can say. Power with negative exponents. Negative exponents. That is, the power is negative. So we simply have, if it is a raised to the power minus m, this is, the power is negative, power is negative. To convert this into positive power, so what we need to do, we need to write the reciprocal of a, we have to take the reciprocal of base. We'll take the reciprocal of base and the power becomes positive. So we get 1 upon a whole raised to the power, positive power, that is m. If we have, let's take one more, if it is a upon b whole raised to the power m, this is to be converted as positive exponent, a upon b. The reciprocal of a upon b is b upon a. Reciprocal of a upon b is b upon a, and the power will become positive. Minus m tha to plus m ho jayega, positive power. This is negative exponent, this is positive exponent. Let's discuss some questions based on this. For example, if you have to find out simply 2 raised to the power minus 3, 2 raised to the power minus 3. Now the reciprocal of 2, it is 1 upon 2. We have to apply the bracket here. Negative power get converted into positive power. 1 upon 2 power 3 means 1 upon 2 into 1 upon 2 into 1 upon 2, and this is equal to 1 upon 8. Second example, if it is 2 upon 5 raised to the power minus 2, 2 upon 5 raised to the power minus 2, Now students, what is the reciprocal of 2 upon 5? Reciprocal of 2 upon 5 is 5 upon 2. 5 upon 2. Power negative thi, positive ho jayegi. So 5 upon 2 raised to the power 2. Now this is equal to 5 upon 2 into 5 upon 2. So this is equal to 25 upon 4 is the value. Okay, let's take one more example. Example number 3. Third example. 1 upon 2 raised to the power minus 1 plus 1 upon 3 raised to the power minus 2. 1 upon 3 raised to the power minus 2. So here, first let's write this in the form of positive exponent. तो 1 upon 2 power minus 1 को जब positive exponent के form में लिखेंगे, तो ये हो जाएगा 2 upon 1. 1 upon 2 का reciprocal 2 upon 1. Power negative थी तो positive हो गई power 1. Plus 1 upon 3 का reciprocal होगा 3 upon 1. Power negative थी तो positive कर दीजिए power 2. So this is basically equal to 2 plus 3 square is 9 and 2 plus 9 is 11 is the answer. Right? Next one is a power m into b power m. देखिए इससे पहले हमने किया था a power m into a power n. यहाँ पे वहाँ पे base same था. यहाँ base different है power same. A power m into b power m that is equal to a into b whole raised to the power m. For example, if it is 2 raised to the power 3 into 5 raised to the power 3. 2 raised to the power 3 into 5 raised to the power 3 will get 2 into 5 whole raised to the power 3. And that is equal to 10 raised to the power 3. So this is equal to 1000 is the answer. Another example we can take. If it is 3 upon 5 whole raised to the power 7 multiplied by 3 upon 5 whole raised to the power minus 5. Okay. So first what we need to do, we have two options here. Two methods to solve this question. One is simply we can see they have the same base 3 upon 5 and we need to multiply. So using the law that is a power m into a power n is equal to a power m plus n. So this can be directly done as 3 upon 5 whole raised to the power 7 plus minus 5. And that will be equal to 3 upon 5 whole raised to the power 2. So its value is 9 upon 25. This is one method. We have another method also. So what we can do? We can just first convert this in the form of positive exponent. Okay? Right, so this is the correct one. That is, so when if we convert this in the form of positive exponent, second method, let's discuss the other method also. Second method, if we convert this in the form of positive exponent, second method, तो उसमें हम क्या करेंगे कि ये negative exponent को हम positive exponent के form में convert करेंगे. तो ये वाला तो already positive है. 3 upon 5 whole power 7 multiplied by, जब हम इसको positive में convert करेंगे तो 3 by 5 का reciprocal हो गया 5 upon 3. So the second method, what we do, 3 upon 5 raised to the power minus 5, this is negative exponent, we'll write it as a positive exponent. So here this is already positive, so this is 3 upon 5 whole power 7 multiplied by 5 upon 3 whole power 5. Negative exponent is written as positive exponent. But we see here, the bases are not same, powers are not same, so we cannot apply a power m into a power n. We cannot apply a power m into b power m. So what we need to do? We have to take it 3 power 7. This is 3 power 7. 3 power 7 upon 5 power 7 multiplied by 5 power 5 upon 5 power 7. So now this can be written as 3 power 7. 3 power 7. Now this can be written as 3 power 5. Now this can be written as 3 power 7 upon 3 power 5 multiplied by 5 power 5 upon 5 power 7. Now you can see here we can apply the division rule because the bases are same. Again here also we can apply the division rule because the bases are same. So this is equal to 3 power 7 minus 5, which is equal to 2, multiplied by 5 power 5 minus 7, so it is 5 power minus 2, or 3 square is 9 and 5 power minus 2 will be 1 upon 25. So your answer is 9 upon 25. Okay, so this way we need to apply the laws of exponents and simplify the questions. Sixth rule, that is a power m divided by b power m. Now again we see the power is same, the bases are different. So here power is same, so this will be equal to same power. So we can take it as power m, whole power m, and this is a upon b. A power m divided by b power m, this is equal to a upon b whole raised to the power m. Right? So these are the laws of exponents. Now let's solve some more examples based on this. If you have to find the value of now using laws of exponents, 3 power 0 into 4 power minus 1 into 2 power 2. 3 power 0 plus 4 power minus 1 multiplied by 2 raised to the power 2. So we see 3 raised to the power 0, this is equal to 1. 4 power minus 1, this will be equal to 1 upon 4. And 2 square, this is equal to 4. So now simply the question becomes 1 plus 1 upon 4 multiplied by 4, which can be equal to, taking LCM, 4 plus 1, 5 upon 4 into 4. So now 4, 4 gets cancelled. So the answer is 5. We have used the law of exponent. A raised to the power 0 is equal to 1. A power minus n is equal to 1 upon a whole raised to the power m. And here we have calculated the value of the exponent. Okay? Okay, next example is find the value of 3 power minus 1 plus 4 power minus 1 plus 5 power minus 1 whole raised to the power 0. So in this, no solution is to be done. The answer is simply 1, because any number, ye pura ek number ho gaya, a power 0 is equal to 1, therefore the answer is 1. Now let's see the b part is minus 2 upon 3 whole power minus 2 whole power 2. So first of all, if you apply this a power m whole raised to the power n, this will be equal to minus 2 upon 3 whole raised to the power minus 2 into 2. So this becomes minus 2 upon 3 whole raised to the power minus 4. Now further, the negative exponent is to be converted in the form of positive exponent. Negative exponent to be converted in the form of positive exponent. So this will be equal to minus 2 by 3 ka reciprocal minus 3 upon 2. Negative को positive में convert किया, power 4. Now this is equal to minus 3 whole power 4 upon 2 whole power 4. Now minus 3 power 4 is equal to 81. Minus 3 into minus 3 into minus 3 into minus 3, and 2 power 4 is 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, so that is 16, and this is the answer. Okay students, so this way we have learned the laws of exponents. Now with the help of this, your assignment part or your homework is you can solve the questions of exercise 12.1. Few questions we have already done. Exercise 12.1 of NCERT book. Question number 1st, 2nd and 3rd. Question 1, 2 and 3. Thank you. Have a nice day.